Hi everybody, Nicole Fecto from Better Homes and Gardens Masiello here, and today I'm going to talk briefly about if you should do upgrades to your house before you list it. This is a question I get a lot from homeowners when I come out on listing consultations, and we walk through the house and they say, well, we're gonna upgrade the kitchen, we're gonna upgrade the bathroom, and can you give us a price based on that? And so my advice is always to sell your house without doing those upgrades to it right now in this market. We are in a market right now where it is a seller's market, it's strong. We're also in a market where building materials are very highly priced, where it's hard to get contractors to show up to a job, and it's just hard to get work done, and it's costing a lot more. So to be able to realize that investment is pretty slim right now. And houses are selling without the upgrades. So my advice right now is don't upgrade it, leave it as is and price it properly for the market. And it's still gonna get bid up out of, just like rockets. So the other thing is that your agent could give you a price, a value of what it's worth right now as is, and then a value of what it's worth remodeled. And I do that a lot for people just so they can look over and see what the different costs are and really get all the information. So the other question I get is, you know, after your house is on the market, you get an offer on it, a buyer has a home inspection, should we sell the house as is? If a buyer comes back with a request or something is found wrong with my house, should I say, go pound sand and we're selling the house as is? And so this is really dependent on the problem, dependent on the buyers, dependent on the house, and dependent on the market. My advice to my sellers is always to be willing to walk away from a deal. I find that when my sellers are willing to walk away, that we wind up in a much better position financially. So I like to maybe test the waters a little bit with buyers and just say, no, we're not doing any of this, and see how much we could actually get away with. One of my little negotiating strategies, and it works quite well, and it leaves a lot of money in my seller's pockets. So, but it depends. I mean, if the house is a problem house to begin with, and your buyer is a rural development buyer, and you have a failed septic system, and there's probably a low likelihood of getting another buyer hooked, then it might be worth rethinking that strategy. So it's a case-by-case basis, but most sellers right now are just saying, as is, where is, home inspections for informational purposes only, and sellers are still getting away with that right now in this market. So if you have any questions about buying, selling, investing, please send me a message. If you're watching this on Facebook Live, or if you're watching this on my YouTube channel, you can text me at 207-251-9535. Thanks a lot.